This is my friend AJ. He lives in Georgia with his mom, his two sisters, and his two nephews. AJ grew up like any other American kid, only he was born with cerebral palsy. But that hasn't stopped him from pursuing the things that he loves. He was an honor student in high school and has since become an inspiring actor. AJ has been in music videos, short films, and was recently featured in an award-winning documentary.
I love being active. I love being around people. And I guess since I'm being honest, one thing about me is I'm really good at, telling stories and very talkative and good at acting, but I suck at improv.
AJ's cerebral palsy is complicated by a condition called spastic quadriplegia. He does not have use of his arms or legs and is legally blind. So he is in need of around-the-clock care, which he has received from his loving family. His mother, Cynthia, his two sisters, and his grandmother have been his caretakers for the past 32 years. But 2 years ago, his grandmother passed away suddenly, leaving Cynthia as AJ's sole full-time care provider. 9 years ago, AJ started to have problems with his kidneys. He has had to have over 50 operations to deal with this issue. He has had to spend a lot of time in the hospital and going to the doctor. With the complications of AJ's health and need for care, the financial burden has become too much. They lost their home and even had to give up their dog. AJ, his mom, his sisters, and nephews are now in constant search for a place to stay. Good friends open their home to AJ and his family, but his need to use the bathroom laying down means he needs space and privacy. As guests in someone else's home, this makes it difficult and uncomfortable for everyone. This was their last option. It begins with taking AJ up 2 flights of stairs, but the last time they tried it, Cynthia stopped and began to cry. She was exhausted and scared that she couldn't make it and would injure AJ or possibly both of them.
AJ sleeps on that couch. This is my oldest grandson. Say hi.
Hi.
And we, the rest of us, which is 5, will sleep on this 4. When AJ has to take a bowel movement, I'll put him back in his chair and we'll go through the kitchen area and I'll take him out the back door and I will sit his wheelchair in that area and prepare him to use the bathroom. And then he'll do it outside, and I'll clean him up outside and dispose of the things down the steps, and then bring him back in.
Lately, they are always tired because there are too many people sharing one bed, or they have to sleep on the floor. Cynthia needs her rest to be strong enough to pick up AJ on a daily basis. So staying with friends has become very difficult. They stay in a hotel when they can afford it.
I've spent the day in the hotel. I didn't really go out today. I've just been laying down. I'm not feeling very well. I think I have a urinary tract infection.
Recently, AJ was diagnosed with a persistent kidney infection causing kidney stones. The doctors are still trying to figure out why the kidney stones keep happening. Lately, he has been too sick to get out of bed, so they decided to go to the emergency room. It's now 4 a.m. Mm-hmm.
Diaz and his primary care doctor
saying it is hurting him. That can cause, could be the reason, okay?
Okay.
Because that infection.
Okay. You're about to go home, okay?
Yeah, that's what it was called. That's what they said.
Make you very sick. Yeah.
Okay. I was, Mom.
After they were discharged, they had just enough time to go back to the hotel to get a little sleep before checkout later that day.
We're going to ride around for most of the day until my sister gets off work, and then we'll regroup and figure out where we're going to go.
The family lost their SUV several months ago. They now travel in a borrowed car. Cynthia serves double duty taking care of AJ and watching her 2 grandkids. So getting them around is a serious challenge, especially as AJ's health issues persist. In the past month, with multiple trips to the ER and many trips to the doctors, they've been too tired to find a place to stay. His sisters and nephews have been able to stay with friends, but Cynthia and AJ's only option has been to sleep in their car. Our goal is to help AJ's family find a new home. Their dream is to relocate to California, where they have a better support system and access to more services for AJ's condition. But in the meantime, we want to help them secure a place to live, where they can rest, be safe, and be together as a family.
Smile, though your heart is aching.